Anyway, I had a really good chat with Ree from Bad Gills Radio. Hold on, let me pause this. Because apparently I can't speak to you and video log at the same time. I had a really good Google Plus Hangout video chat, whatever, with Ree from Bad Gals Radio. That's bad. Hold on. See, I knew I'd forget. Bad Gals, BADGALS / radio.com. And by slash, I mean, is it a hyphen? Like if you get married and you want to keep your name and your husband's name, then you hyphenate the name, you know, the slash in the middle, or the minus sign, whatever. It was an awesome chat. In spite of the fact that we were having technical difficulties, I couldn't really always hear her, and sometimes I could read her lips to know what she was saying, then other times I couldn't understand what she was saying, and so I'd have to be like, stop. I didn't hear anything after he. It was a really, really good chat. This is a straight water, by the way, because I had what Anderson Cooper would call an incident today. In other words, I had the backdoor trots. So, yeah, I'm waiting for a phone call. I'm gonna go ahead and turn this thing up. The phone call was supposed to come at 11 a.m., but you know how people are. As in, people can say, I'm gonna call you at 11 o'clock, and then they call at 10:45 or whatever. So yeah, try not to get distracted by my emails. But anyway, one of the things that I appreciated about my chat with Ree is not that I feel like I need validation, but it is sometimes good to get validation regardless. Like I have been telling my mother and everybody I know, Tyler Perry is gay. And it's not just because he dresses up in women's clothes. That's a transvestite, okay? Like Eddie Izzard. Gay is something completely different. I said, y'all mark my words, Tyler Perry is going to come out of the closet at one point. Not because he was molested when he was a child. Has nothing to do with that. He's gay. I keep telling y'all people that. People in my real life that I actually know. But all these black people gonna get all upset when I say that shit. But it was nice for someone else to say, And apparently she hates everybody I hate too. She ain't down with Oprah either. Yay. She's like, well, a lot of people on my blog said they hate Oprah too, but you know, I don't know who they are. So to get validation from someone that I actually like and have spoken to for several years online, you know, I'm not the only one. I'm not the only black woman in America who does not appreciate Oprah. Okay. And I was telling her that I'm gonna try to get my cousin to come over here and make a video with me to explain to you people. And by you people, I mean blog readers, video watchers, all that shit. I'm gonna try to get my cousin to come over and explain to you people that this is me, 100 time 100% of the time, 24/7, 365. See what I'm saying? Always. I'm always what you call a bitch. I'm always what some of you call mean. I'm always, you know, saying it like it is. I'm always telling you the truth. I'm not going to lie to you. Why would I lie to you? You don't know me. I don't know you. I don't give a shit what you think. So why would I lie to you about who I am? And she's like, mm-hmm. Was also nice to be able to explain my, well, some of the shit we don't need to talk about because it's none of your business, and certain people watch these videos whether I give them the link or not. That's all that needs to be said. But yeah, it was great to talk to her. This is the first time we've ever spoken. Normally we just speak through comments or whatever that I leave on her blog or she leaves on my blog, and I really need to start reading her blog more thoroughly because in the beginning it used to get on my nerves because I got to her page and I didn't know how to turn the radio off. And it also is called Bad Gals Radio, so I was like, but surely there's some way to turn the radio off. And she told me, and I figured it out, but other stuff has happened. And I have chronic CRS, so, you know, I don't always remember how to turn the radio off. So I go to her blog, and I'm scrolling down looking for the place where I can turn the radio off. So, yeah. We had a conversation until about 5:45 when it was time for me to take my meds at 6 because my back started hurting and, you know, I started getting a headache and all that stuff. But so I went up to the bathroom about 5:45 and the boy was like, Mom, what if I want to stay home from school today? I said, what if you do? He said, well, can I? I said, I don't give a shit. Because, you know, he makes good grades. It's not like it was when he was in middle school and every day it was like, Mom, can I stay home? Mom, can I stay home? Mom, I don't want to go to school. Mom, can I stay home? This, you know, for him to miss a day of school without all the little whores, and I love you, Evan, give me a hug, Evan, 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 Evan. Then, you know, he really is not feeling well. What is today? Wednesday. Of course. Oh my God, I think he picks Wednesdays on purpose because the doctor's office is closed on Wednesdays. But, you know, he hasn't missed school enough for me to be sent a letter saying we're gonna... Okay, put it this way. The redneck that used to live beside me, she had 4 kids, but every single day, at least one of her kids stayed home from school. And so she has been to jail at least twice that I know of for, I don't remember what it's called, but for not letting her kids go to school. She's been to jail at least twice for that I know of. And this was... If Evan was like 6 or 7, it had been at least 10 years ago, but in the few year span that I knew her and was talking to her daily, she'd been to school twice. I mean, to jail twice for that, not making her kids go to school. She should... And I know that her two older daughters have had a child, a baby, and I know that her oldest niece, who was also living with her because her sister died from, was it kidney failure or liver failure? I don't remember. But her sister, who was only, I think, 27 at the time, died from that liver failure. So the redneck got custody of her 4 kids, which was 2 older girls and 2 twin boys. So she had 8 kids living with her. And I know that her oldest niece has already had 1 baby. So in the 10 years since I've really seen her, I'm assuming that all the girls have gotten pregnant at least once. I forget what the fuck I was gonna say. Because it didn't have anything to do with teenage pregnancies or anything. I was just...
Yeah, I was just talking and stuff and whatnot and things.
Told you that I hate water. I hate water. I mean, I don't. Part of it, I think, is from when I was a teenager and I tried so many times to kill myself by taking all those pills and whatever else. And I always drank water, tap water, but this was in Maryland. I always took tap water when I was trying to do that. So I think something about water made me feel like I'm finna take a bunch of pills, so I better, you know, drink some water. I don't know. I don't know why I hate water so much, but I do. But this is bottled water, so it doesn't taste like that fucking tap water that we have that smells like bleach. Straight up bleach. I'm surprised that when he washes his clothes here that he doesn't fade them or they don't get, you know, bleached or something, because I mean, seriously, the amount of chlorine in that water, I don't know how anybody can drink that. That's why I told my mom for Christmas I either wanted one of those Brita filters or one of those things where you can take water and make your own soda. Okay. I guess that's about it. Because I was watching Real Housewives of Beverly Hills. And, I ain't got nothing else to say, really. For now. I'm not sleepy. I'm trying to wake myself up so I'll be awake for this phone call that I'm expecting. Oh, I did have to turn on the air conditioning last night because I know that in my previous videos I said it was supposed to get up to 80 degrees, but it was only supposed to get up to 70 degrees. So last night it was like 78 degrees when I finally, this morning at 5:45, when I finally got ready to go to sleep, it was 78 degrees in the room. And so I opened the back door like a foot wide and put up, you know, my fake screen to keep the moths out, and it was just too damn hot. And finally at maybe 6 or something I told the boy to come down here and shut the door and turn on the air conditioning. And then I ate myself a Nutella sandwich, took all my meds, and took a nice little nap. Till I started having them diarrhea pains, which, you know, were bad. But I didn't want to take anything to stop the diarrhea because, you know, if I take something like that, I get constipated. And ever since my grandmother told me how she takes fish oil every day and she's been regular ever since, I've been taking that fish oil. And I just didn't want to get constipated because that's not a nice feeling for me. I don't feel right if I don't have a bowel movement every day. Okay. So I went up to the bathroom and I was just trying to suffer through the pains and knock wood. Does plywood count? Knock plywood. Oh, here's wood. Knock wood, the diarrhea is over. So, that's all. Talk to y'all later. Bye.